Please take. Jaya,
sir.
I found that you have a lot of hobbies. Practicing community kitchen, gardening, learning different types of hand embroidery techniques, etc. Okay.
Sir.
What is this practicing community kitchen gardening?
So I live in a gated community, sir. It has 106 units. And while getting together at the evenings, we started discussing about growing plants in our balcony. So we have a very limited space in each house. So we started discussing about growing plants. Mainly we started with the green leaf vegetables, sir. So now we are able to grow a decent amount of vegetables in our own balcony, as well as we are using the open space areas that is available in the community to plant some of the herbal plants and all that, sir. And maybe in the future we'll be able to buy and sell produce from each other as well, sir, if it is
okay.
Doing well.
I find you have taken political science and international relations.
Yes, sir.
Why?
So international relations these days, it is gaining more importance nowadays, sir. As well, because India
it was always important. Why
these days?
It was always important.
Now India is aspiring to be a leader in the international arena.
Okay.
As well, there is a reciprocation from the other countries as well, sir. Other countries are also looking up to India. They are expecting India to play a major role in the international arena these days. So there is a proper reciprocation as well, sir. So
okay.
I find that people.
First option is foreign service.
First option is Indian foreign service.
First preference is foreign service.
Yes, sir.
Okay, very nice. How foreign service is different from other services?
So when it comes to foreign services,
IAS, IPS, etc.
Yes, sir. So if one who's working in the foreign services is acting as an ambassador who's carrying the ambitions of his country to the other countries, rest of the countries in the world, sir. When we are working in the other services, we are going to work for the people of India, and we are going to work according to the system that is available in the country. But when we work for Indian foreign services, we take the ambitions of our country to the other parts of the world. We are going to get mutually benefited out of that.
What is an All India service and what is a central service?
There are three All India services. Right?
Which are they?
Indian Administrative Services, Indian Police Services and Indian Forest Services.
Forest, okay. And what are the central services?
I think apart from those three, like Indian Defence Estates or Indian...
Where there is no cadre. All these three have got cadres, state cadres.
Okay.
Where they don't have cadres, it is central services.
Okay.
Foreign services, which of them? Which of these? Central service or India, the other service?
Central service.
Or AIS, All India Service?
This is Central Service, sir. Indian Foreign Service is Central Service.
Okay. Will you tell us something on Brexit?
So, Brexit, the United Kingdom, they were part of European Union and now they are willing to come out of the European Union, sir. The reason stated is...
What are the date?
Sir?
What was the date?
I think March 31, 2019.
It has already happened.
Yes.
31st January this year, only 23 days back. Okay. Tell me on Brexit.
Sir, basically United Kingdom, they wanted to strengthen their boundaries, sir. They are not happy with so many people coming inside United Kingdom because when they are part of European Union, the people from the other European countries, the Schengen area, Without visa, they can come into United Kingdom. They need not even have a work visa, sir. So
that is Schengen agreement. That is Schengen agreement. Okay.
So the United States, they don't want such a immigration to happen, sir. They want only highly skilled labor to come into United Kingdom. So they want to strengthen their boundaries, sir. In the first place.
They called it a loss of sovereignty. Being a part of EU is a loss of sovereignty. Why? Why did they call so? UK called it. When you are members in EU, we have lost a part of our sovereignty because all laws, etc., they are in Brussels. So Brussels bureaucracy was dominating.
Yes, sir.
What are the other points?
Actually, I didn't get the question properly, sir.
What are the other reasons as to why England wants to go away?
Other reasons.
So to safeguard their job and they are not willing to give benefits to people who are coming into their country, because if
Okay.
they come into their country, sir, slowly they bring in their families as well, and they also bring the extended families, and they get the benefits out of it. Because country like United Kingdom, they give a universal health system as well, sir. So the cost wise, the NHS, National Health Services. So the cost wise, if there are so many people coming into United Kingdom, that is being a cost to the country, sir. So
Why is Ireland boundary is a problem?
so Northern Ireland,
Northern Ireland and Irish Republic.
yes sir.
Why that is a problem? You must have read several times. Soft border, hard border, what are they?
Actually, they are asked, they are the Northern Ireland and the Republic of Ireland, they are wanting that. Even though United Kingdom is coming out of Brexit, but still there should not be a hard border between Northern Ireland and the Republic of Ireland, is what they claim, sir. But I don't know the history why there is a.
As per which agreement? It should not be hard border. As per which agreement?
United Kingdom is asking for it,
Yes.
sir.
Have you heard of Good Friday Agreement? Have
Good Friday Agreement.
you heard of that?
Yes, sir.
That was decided so that the border should be soft. Now, what has been decided tentatively? Any goods coming from UK to Northern Ireland, they will be free. But to Southern Ireland, if they go, then there should be there must not be an impression that they are there for other countries. That is now tentative, they have agreed. Now there will be a period in which still so many things will happen as per the old agreement. So practically it is not final. There is a tentative
Transition.
period by which they will settle down to everything. Okay, please.
Well, Jay Chitra,
Sir.
you were from Dharmapuri district, born in Dhawal district. So you have not lived there, or you were.
So I did my schooling till 10th standard in Dharmapuri, sir.
What was the problem in Dharmapuri district as far as girl child is concerned?
So Dharmapuri, feticide and female infanticide was much prevalent in Dharmapuri, sir. Even today, Dharmapuri is listed in the central government's list that multi-pronged approach should be taken to eradicate that female feticide and infanticide. Female infanticide has been, to a larger extent, it has been controlled now, sir. But female feticide, it is still prevalent, sir, in Dharmapuri.
Well, you have taken international political science, international relation. Is globalization irrelevant today?
So, for the developed countries, from the angle of developed countries, it may look like globalization is not needed anymore, sir. But in the idea of developing countries who still did not reap the benefits of globalization, as like the developed countries, we still look forward to taking forward the multilateralism, sir.
But how do you say that for developed countries globalization is not relevant? In fact, I feel I would say that it is more relevant to them than even developing countries.
So, but because if you take US or UK, they are going, it looks like they are going towards protectionism concepts, sir. They have wanted to protect their domestic players, and so they are imposing tariffs on the goods that are coming from the developing countries. Even they are not ready to accept some reforms that should happen in the international organizations. Because if we say United Nations, sir, in the Security Council, they are not ready to extend the membership of permanent players in the Security Council. So it looks like they are not ready to accept the major role played by the developing countries, sir. But in countries like India and the countries that are around India, sir, we did not reap that much of benefits because we have been a market for those countries to bring in their finished goods into our market, sir, from the developed countries. We have just provided our labor and we have just provided our raw materials to them, sir, and we are buying finished goods from them. So those benefits still the developing countries have not reaped out of this globalization, sir. So we are, our country like India, we are stressing that we need multilateralism, we need globalization, but it looks like the developed countries are taking a step back from it, sir.
And you mean to say that these developed countries, on the other hand, in developed countries are importing most of the goods from either China or India, which are developing, or to say Bangladesh, Vietnam, and other developing countries. So most of the countries in the world, they are supplied with Chinese goods. So in that case, how do you say that developed countries are supplying us? In fact, it is the country like China. China is number one in supplying all goods to the most of the developed countries. You find everywhere, US or Australia, anywhere, Europe, it is Chinese goods are flooding the market, followed by maybe Sri Lankan, maybe Bangladeshi textiles or Indian, our Tirupur textiles, all these things will also be going there. So, and why they are allowing this to come? Because they are not doing any charity. Because they are able to produce it at a less expensive rate and supply them. And even at times, the ecological cost, environmental cost is quite heavy, especially leather and textile industries. So it is not that, but the protectionism is coming in US, protectionism is coming for job. In fact, not for the goods,
okay,
it's for jobs. Where they want the Donald Trump actually succeeded mainly because job for Americans. We'll provide job for Americans. You may come get second term also now, saying that it's the same plank. Okay. Then you were working in private sector for till 2015, and you were drawing a salary of 12 lakh per annum.
So that was when I worked in London, sir.
Yes. And why do you want to come to this, I think, which will give you only 50% of that income?
One reason is, anyways, we were not willing to get settled in London, so we wanted to come back to India. That is one main reason. The second reason is, so the civil services has always, I was very strong in my mind that this clearing the civil service exam and to be a part of the government is a, gives me a greater sense of achievement, sir. That is one. And second reason is, any right action, any taken by me as an officer will have a good positive impact on so many lives of people. And third reason is, sir, I wanted to show the women that it is possible even after marriage, we can keep our ambitions alive, even if we get married, even if we have children, or even if we feel, I mean, there are so many problems today in conceiving the child itself, sir, and people are getting into depression. So I wanted to show people, at least women in my district, that it is possible even after marriage, sir.
Well, see, the climate change is the problem, global problem. And do you feel the countries in the world are addressing it properly? You know about the 2015 the Paris Agreement. The progress card is coming on this every now and then on media. What do you feel about it?
I honestly feel that the steps that are taken by the countries is not sufficient, sir. Because even a country like US, they are coming out, they came out of this Paris Agreement, and President Trump is strongly encouraging the coal thermal power plants, coal extraction and all that. So that itself is because they have to be an example for the other countries, but still they are going in the other direction. That is one, sir. And as well, even countries like our country, we did not still invest so much. We are not doing enough research towards the renewable energy resources and all that. So still, even in our country, coal is, thermal power plants is being a dominant energy.
Are you sure?
At least till now, yes, sir.
See, in fact, 67% of our energy comes from thermal power plants. So, and that used to, and I think in the last 2-3 years, it has come down to around 60%. Our aim is to reduce it to 43% and increase the solar and wind energy, not conventional energy. So it is not that we are not doing anything. Our solar mission is really doing well. In fact, we have got the largest solar plant in Kamudi in Narnagar district. And we are also part of the solar alliance, not only India, we are also promoting it in other developing countries. and as a part of solar alliance.
We are doing, but maybe it is not adequate for arresting
right.
what we have planned to do, that is 1.5 or 2. But we are doing, and as you say, US has not signed, US is the, and the China, US, China, and followed by India, we have the emitters. And in China and India are fast growing economies compared to the target. Europe also is the.
But Europe is doing better in this thing. But I think you have to brush up something on climate change and what we are addressing. And the problem between our the Paris Agreement and WTO, some of them, WTO is it's a stumbling block in achieving this. These things I think you should brush
up. Okay.
You're answering about Brexit. There is a school of thought which says that this is a sign of the beginning of the disintegration of European Union. Is it correct? Do you agree with this school of thought?
Sir, I think I agree with that school of thought, because even some other countries, I don't remember the countries exactly, sir, even they are opting to come out of European Union, sir. So, migration is one of the major reasons for this, sir, but still, yeah, I agree to this.
But even a few years back, strong proponents of globalization have argued, but now they argue that this is an irreversible process. We cannot go back to the 1991 days, even if we wish. And that argument has got strengthened by the new inventions in technology, science and technology. The world has become a global village. So in that angle, how can you say that there is a merit in the school of thought which says that we are heading towards pre-globalization, it's not de-globalization?
So actually, with respect to European Union, I thought because some countries have got difference of opinion compared to European Union, like United Kingdom, sir, because they did not want to follow the rules of the European Union and all that. But definitely, we cannot come out of globalization, sir, because there is complex interdependence. It's not just interdependence, it's complex interdependence between countries, sir. So we cannot go to pre-globalization. But rather than being into a particular group, countries are willing to extend their agreements with the other countries in the world as well, sir. So today, compared to the importance of international organizations like WTO, countries are willing to sign free trade agreements with the other countries, so that bilateralism and regionalism, that is gaining more importance, sir. So even at the within European Union, there may be some countries who have difference of opinion with the European Union, sir. But it doesn't mean that they wanted to come out of globalization, but it is also not possible, sir, because of the complex interdependence. Because today we have got, apart from the movement of goods, we have also got movement of labor today, sir. So yeah, pre-globalization is not possible, but countries are trying, not willing to be a part of only a particular group. They are willing to extend their agreements with the other countries in the world as well, sir.
Well, this number one choice is here for itself. Is a childhood dream or
no? So Indian Foreign Services is not my childhood dream, sir. To get into civil services and definitely being an IAS officer was my initial thought. But now, after living in London for some period and understanding the importance of foreign relations today,
getting into civil service was your childhood dream.
Yes, sir.
But why you have wasted 4 years in engineering and 2 years in MBA? 6 years you have wasted.
So I cannot call that a waste, because any education per se, it will definitely help me in the work that I do, that I need to do. So, but engineering, it was not my own decision, sir. It was a collective decision, sir.
Family decision.
It was a collective decision, sir. And
For what? Personal?
Sir, they thought even if civil services was my ambition, because of this uncertainty, they said I should need a fallback thing. So I should be a going to engineering or going to HR field. So they thought there is so much of uncertainty when getting to civil service. Also, sir, the initial periods after my graduation, there was a need of financial support as well, sir. So I just got into the job.
If you don't mind, you have not mentioned anything about your father.
So my father is no more, sir.
How was he actually?
He was into business, sir. Rice and oil business.
At a higher level or?
So basically in the rice mill, they get the grains from government related. So they get grains and then the husk is removed and the rice is distributed to the public distribution system. So, so it was, he was involved into that rice mill.
Economically it was a medium level.
Yes, sir.
See, why am I asking this question? Don't mistake me.
That's
because you come from a community which is very, very little bit slightly ahead of the scheduled caste
issues. Yes, sir.
There is nothing much difference between these two countries. Nothing personal, please understand this. And accomplishing these things, your graduation and post-graduation, working in London, coming back to civil service, aspiring to become a civil servant, or something like that. It itself is an achievement, no doubt. But as a woman, as you said that after marriage and after getting into family life, are you aware of the hardships of a diplomat, that the women are diplomat?
So as in the hardships today for every working woman, there are hardships, sir. It can be any job, sir. It is how we balance it, sir. So also I've got a supportive husband who is into IT field and he's also traveling to different countries because of his projects. And so we understand, having lived outside as well, I understand that we can balance it, sir.
Your husband is living abroad?
So he travels on and off to for his project.
He's based here or he's in
He's working for an Indian company, sir, but when there are projects that demands that he should go to the client place, he travels, sir.
He has not appeared for interview. All the four attempts, your choice was IIM, for instance.
Sir, I did not clear my prelims itself, sir. This was the first time I cleared my prelims. So this is the first time I gave my preference as well, sir.
So the first time you are going. Yes. See, what's your view on this, sir? Death sentences for rapes.
So if it acts as a deterrent, I'll be real.
Does it act as a deterrent?
It is not acting as a deterrent, sir. But the capital punishment itself is, if it is not acting as a deterrent, then now I'm not sure what will act as a deterrent to them, sir. So, if
so, in strike terms, you are against the death sentences. Whatever may be the gravity of the crime.
I'm not actually against death sentence, sir. I'm saying death sentence should act as a deterrent for the
It's not acting.
But that is the highest punishment that is given in our.
You're playing safe. You're not giving straight answer.
Sir, because
it can be this way or that way. See, there are some countries which have completely banned death sentence.
130 countries. More than 30 countries. They have banned either in law or in practice.
Yes. He has not a signatory to that.
But right now I can't think about any. What else can be the punishment, sir?
There is a saying that it is not the severity of the punishment or the inevitability of it which prevents a crime. That means whoever commits a crime must be punished. Punishment is inevitable.
It's like this, they say that it's not the severity of the punishment, but it's the certainty of the punishment. That only acts as a deterrent, not the severity. Anyway, what's your view on this freebies culture?
So, actually, freebies, I don't support that idea of giving freebies to the people, sir, because people should. People should read the.
How do you define a freebie? Is giving bicycles to girl children a freebie? Is color television a freebie? Is laptops, mixer grinders a freebie? Is moon meal scheme a freebie?
Uh, giving,
or is it a affirmative action?
Does some fall under the affirmative action, sir, because giving a bicycle to a girl child, because it is also the responsibility of the government to lay roads or give the public transport, effective public transport system, sir. So in those areas, if government is not able to fulfill those conditions, they are giving those cycles to the girl children so that they can increase the strength of the girl children in the schools. It falls under the affirmative action, sir. Noon meal scheme, again the objective was the same, sir, because people were students were coming from the poor background, malnutrition problem, and so they will not be able to concentrate in their studies and all that, and to increase the strength of the students in the school, noon meal scheme was implemented, sir. So all these things fall under affirmative action, but giving this mixy
grinders
and all, I don't think it's a good idea, sir, because people, those are some basic needs, sir. If those basic needs are filled, people are not able to think about that, sir. So people have to think about what are the policies that the government they are going to bring in if they are coming into the in case they are forming the government.
Don't you think this mixy grinder and also to remove the drudgery among women? Why don't you say think that it is to remove the drudgery among women?
So rather than giving those mixies and grinders, government can come up with other productive policies and systems, and they can help women get empowered in different ways so that women will be able to afford getting a grinder and mixie.
No, but still, you are talking about empowerment of women. See, women who are housewives, who are homemakers, so they undergo a lot of drudgery. And this is only part of removing some drudgery among them so that and they can't afford to buy them. So government was subsidizing or giving it free to them. So is there anything wrong in that?
So the intention may be if the intention is to help the women, it is okay, sir. But it should not be a factor that covers their negative, sir. If for example, there is a scam on the government or something like that is discussed in the among the public, but coming again and giving the freebies, it should not help cover all those negative things of the government, sir.
No, I understand. I agree with you that freebies per se should not be given, and but certain things like cycles for the school girl child, and this even I would say the mixie or grinder for, because it has become a necessity for every household, but poor people can't afford. Maybe it should be only given to those people who can't afford it. Need not be given to everyone.
I find some kind of a contradiction in the way you have answered, because one is you said that you wanted to come back to India, that's why that was your intention, but you seem to have given foreign services.
So that is again the reason I gave foreign.
I feel you went on a tour abroad for a year, you like London, so now you actually want to spend your life abroad, that's the reason you want to get into foreign service.
Sir, it's not like that, sir, because even if you are working for Indian Foreign Service, you are going to work for the government of India, sir. So, and today because of the relevance of...
What you said, you want to come back to India, but you are actually going out of India now. How is it balancing you? I find something is off about it. So anyway, so your hobbies, you have mentioned that you have done a paper, The Ramayan Way, Human Resource Management. What Ramayan have you read?
What Ramayan have I read? I did not actually read books, but I did see some of the movies made by.
Based on that, you have made a paper presentation.
So my paper presentation was about team composition, sir. I was able to get some insights from Ramayanam because the topic given was like that. What are the insights that you can take from Ramayanam? So I did prepare a paper on team composition and got insights from Ramayanam.
Okay. So can you name a few Ramayana, different types of Ramayana written by different authors?
So Valmiki Ramayanam, Kamba Ramayanam.
Anything else?
So I can remember.
Okay. So when we were talking about Brexit, so is Brexit good for any Indian companies? What about Tata Motors? Is it good for Tata Motors or is it bad for Tata Motors?
So the Indian companies that are operating in United Kingdom.
Talk to me about Tata Motors. Is it good for Tata Motors, Brexit, or is it bad for Tata?
I'm not not sure if Tata Motors is having a, what kind of operation in United Kingdom, but my general idea is that companies who are having headquarters in United Kingdom, sir, they are worried about whether they'll be able to do the same kind of trade with the other countries in the European Union. So that is main, and the companies have started shifting their headquarters to the other countries in the Europe, sir.
Okay. So, what is this? University of Cambridge. Hmm? So, what is Cambridge? Where is Cambridge located?
Cambridge is located in United Kingdom.
What is it famous for?
What's
famous? It's not famous. Okay. So, when we are talking about protectionism and everything, so don't you think Gandhian thought of self-reliant villages, that actually goes against this entire concept of nations globalizing with each other and becoming more and more intertwined and intermeshed, dependent on each other? So is it not negating his thoughts of self-reliant villages? Globalization, do you find globalization is in contradiction to Mahatma Gandhi's thoughts?
Yes, sir, it is, because Mahatma Gandhi, as you said, he wanted the self-reliance concept, but the globalization is also advantageous because it works on the principle of cost advantage, sir. If we can get something from the other countries with cost benefit, why not? That is the concept of globalization.
So then why did Gandhi want to have self-reliant villages? What was that he was very skeptical about bringing urban areas into the fold? What was it?
Sir, Gandhiji did not like this materialism concept. He was against this modern nation because of that materialistic thought.
Okay.
Okay. In 1 minute, I will say that your interview is very good. You are very cheerful, trying to take part in the discussion, very nice. But regarding Brexit, Gibraltar is a problem. Gibraltar doesn't want to go out of EU. Scotland will one day go out of England because the English people do not treat them well. There is a great distrust between, you must have known it. They definitely go. Some 2-3 years back, by very slim majority, they were retained. But now, again, sometimes they will go. So these are all problems. Okay, take any others.
Two things. One is the common kitchen, gardening, shuttle badminton, these things we have mentioned in this. So there is no time for us to ask questions on this. But anyway, you prepare shuttle badminton means who are the champions at national level, international level. And Saina Nehwal and this Sindhu and similarly, the men's and the women's receiving the pressure. And gardening, what kind of gardening do you do?
Sir, right now we are growing mainly the green, spinach varieties, sir. All spinach varieties.
Spinach.
All types of spinach varieties we grow, as well as the vegetables to some extent, sir. Like
Kirayala?
Kirayala.
Okay. So the greens, you can say greens to the gardening for nutritional gardening or whatever, or flower gardening. See, what kind of gardening you do? You just prepare over 4-5 points on that. And then common kitchen, what do you mean by that?
It's community kitchen, as in we are within our community, sir, because it's a gated community we live in. We have 106 units, houses within the community. So together we are doing, because now we are ready to even share our produce, buy and sell produce from each other. So it has grown to that level, sir, now.
Yes,
sir. Yes,
you cook something, kirai or?
Sir, in a week, 2 times or 3 times I can take produce from my own garden, sir.
Okay. No, but community kitchen has got a different connotation.
Langar, Punjabi is
community kitchen means the whole community join together and have kitchen instead of individual household having kitchen. That is called community kitchen.
Sir, this is community kitchen gardening. We do the gardening together.
Community kitchen gardening. So it will be physically not separate.
Okay.
Where it is your house?
No, Perumbakkam, sir.
Okay. Perumbakkam. Perumbakkam Lake is full now.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay.
All the best.
So, see, you have got a very, very good potential candidate. You have got everything and you have cleared this time main exam. So, with all confidence, you should go. Only thing is, you have to brush up these items, about each of these items, what I mentioned. See, international relation, any question can be asked. If there is a sky is the limit for that. But immediate thing is about globalization, protectionism, the visit of American president now. These are the things which they will be in the memory, so you can expect questions on that. And why are you aspiring for civil service, foreign service, questions were asked. So you prepared a more convincing answer on this. And about your hobbies you prepare. See, the death sentence and all, when questions like that are asked, you can always say for and against. See, clearly, see, death sentence, are we competent to end life? We have no right to end life. So that is the way why many of the countries have stopped death sentence. Instead, they give life imprisonment for 50 years, 60 years, 100 years, 200 years.
Also natural age. I live 14 years, natural living years.
End of the life, you will be in prison. See, in India, life sentence can be even 14 years. It is not the case in many of the foreign countries. So, that is a question of ethical question, whether we have got right to end life. So, that is why you don't favor or whatever. But for crime, which is very, very... So for the certain crimes, we are still, India is now following that. Death sentence is the ultimate thing for certain crimes. But it is very given only as a last resort. And they have got up to Supreme Court, people go and then. So Nirbhaya case and all, now it is there. So you should relate it to the Nirbhaya case if they ask. So the questions will come on there. Okay? So prepare this, write down, and be thorough with this in answering. So your way of expression, everything is good. Personality, everything is good. Only thing is, this you must slightly firm up. And be very, very big, very brief. And whenever you don't know the answer, you just say, I don't. So don't beat around. Thank you.
Okay.